To start off, let's all lay on our back, preferably with the knees bent and the feet flat on the floor. But if that's not comfortable for now, you can straighten the knees, but keep the feet about mat width apart. Place your arms by your side, palms facing up. Tuck the chin in slightly and close your eyes. And start to shift your awareness inside, looking into your heart. Bring all of you right here, right now, in the present moment. Just breathe in and out through your nostrils. And let's reconnect deeper with our breath. So take your right hand, place the heel of the palm on your lower ribs and rest the right fingers on your abdomen, and place your left hand on the upper ribs. So rest the palms and the fingers on your sternum, and breathe and feel the movements of your ribs as you breathe in and out. Feel the expansion as you inhale, and feel the ribs drawing in as you exhale. Inhale, feel the air fill your lungs. Exhale, feel your lungs push the air out. Inhale, your chest, the abdomen rising. Exhale, the abdomen and chest falling. And continue for a few more rounds of breath. And see if you can feel your heart beating that as well. And after your next exhale, just release your hands by your side and open your eyes. And stay on your back, and if your legs are straightened out, please bend the knees and place the feet flat on the floor. Keep some distance between the feet. And let's do some pelvic tilt exercise. So take an inhale and arch your lower back and point your tailbone towards the mat. Exhale, drop your lower back and sacrum and tuck your tailbone in. Another inhale, arch your lower back. Exhale, tuck the tailbone in and keep going. And try to relax your spine all the way to your neck and see if you can bring your spine, your neck, and your head along in the movement. This is similar to the cat and cow stretch, but in laying down position, the movement is more focused on the lower back area. One more inhale, exhale, and place the sacrum back on the mat and maintain a neutral spine. So this time, extend both of your legs and keep the feet about mat width distance. Stretch your arms up above your head. Take an inhale and exhale and start to slowly side bending to the right, keeping your head and your back in contact with the mat. And at your maximum grip, grab your left wrist with the right hand and pull the left arm gently towards the right. And start to engage your legs, point your feet, and imagine you are squeezing a beach ball in between your knees, and you want to squeeze that ball. So you are kind of attempting to bring the legs together, but they will not meet each other. It's just a muscle activation. And release. Move back to the center. Relax your legs for now. Take another inhale and exhale, side bending to the right side. Head and back still in touch with the mat. And at your max, grab the right wrist with the left hand and pull the right arm gently to the right, to the left, sorry. And again, point your feet, turn on your legs, activate them, and then squeeze that imaginary beach ball in between your knees. Breathe and release back to the center. This time, spread the arms to the side, palms facing up. We then take an inhale and exhale and lift your left pelvis and twist the pelvis to the right side. So your left butt cheek will be lifted off the mat and swing that right arm to the left. So the hips are twisting to the right, but the torso is twisting to the left. Breathe and release back to the center. Take in an inhale and exhale, twist the right pelvis to the left. The right butt cheek will be lifted off the mat and swing the left arm to the right. And breathe. And release back to the center. From here, bend your right knee, interlace the fingers and grab the front of your right knee and pull the right thighs closer to your chest. The left leg that is straightened, activate the leg and point the left foot. Press your sacrum against the mat. Tuck your chin in and start to turn on your core. So you want to scoop your abdomen, bringing that navel towards the spine, and use the strength of your core to inhale and then exhale. Lift your chest, neck, and bring your head closer to your right knee. Stay and breathe. With every exhale, bring your right thigh closer to your chest. Two more breaths and stay here, or you can try and straighten your arms forward. Exhale, release. Straighten that right leg. And this time, bend your left knee. Pull that left thigh close to your chest. Activate the right leg. Point the right foot. Press your sacrum down towards the mat. Tuck your chin in. And start to engage your core. Scoop that navel towards the spine. Inhale and exhale. Use your core strength to lift up
bring your head close to your left knee. Stay and breathe. Hug the thighs closer to your chest with every exhale. Stay here for two more breaths, or maybe extend the arms forward. Exhale to release. Bend the right knee. And this time just make circle. So circle your right thigh bone around the hip socket. Start with a small circle and gradually make the circle bigger. If you experience a clanking sensation, then reduce the range of motion, so make the circle smaller until no more clanking, and reverse the circle. Start to make the circle smaller and come to a stop, and slowly straighten that right leg, bend the left knee, and similarly start to make circle. Start with a small circle and gradually make the circle bigger. And reverse. Start to make the circle smaller and smaller, and come to a stop, and straighten that left leg. One more time, bend that right knee, and this time we'll come into a half happy baby pose. So the right leg will be in the happy baby position. So grab the inside of your right foot with the right hand. And in happy baby, you want to maintain the right thigh parallel to the floor. So with the right hand, gently press the foot down as if you want to bring your knee and the thigh to touch the floor, while maintaining your pelvis neutral, means your left butt cheek should still be in touch with the mat. Stay and breathe. And let's add some movement. So pass the right foot to the left hand and swing the right leg to the left side, and then swing it back to the right and to the left, and keep going side to side. And you could add some extension, so you could maybe extend that right leg into any degree. So extend to the left, extend to the right. Or you can keep the knees, the right knee bent, your choice. See what works for you. One more time to the left, and back to happy baby, and release. Straighten the right leg, bend the left knee, come into half happy baby. So grab from the inside of the left foot, and keep the left thigh parallel to the floor. Press that left foot gently. Remember to keep the pelvis stable, so you are not lifting up on your right side. Breathe. And let's add some movement. So pass the left foot to the right hand, and swing it back to the left, swing to the right, to the left. Maybe add some extension, extend that left leg into any degree, or keep the knees bent. And breathe. One more time to the right. Back into happy baby and release. Straighten both legs. This time roll to your side and push into easy seated position. So even though today's focus will be on the lower body, let's show a bit of love to some parts of our upper body. So let's do some neck circles. So drop your right ear to your right shoulders and drop the head back. Circle to the left. Continue to circle forward across your chest. Back to the right. Circle around the back to the left. Keep going. Move slowly to feel the articulation of the joints in our neck. And reverse. One more circle and come back to center. So push your chin back slightly and then tuck the chin in so you are looking forward and your ears are on top of your shoulders. So in this position, we are bringing our neck into a more neutral alignment with the rest of the spine. Say, and then start to circle your shoulders backward. Again, move slowly and try to make as big circle as possible. Reverse the circle. And release. Keep the shoulders relaxed. And then bring the back of your hands together, pressing against each other. And then start to circle the wrist. And reverse. And release. And let's change our position and sit on your heels. Spread the arms to the side, palms facing up, and then so we will outwardly rotate the arms. So the palms are facing up, and then bring just your forearms, meaning the elbow all the way down to your fingertips, and spiral in the forearms. And remember to keep the shoulders relaxed. And then from here, extend the wrists so your fingertips are facing up to the ceiling. And spread the fingers, not so much, just make sure that there are spaces in between your fingers. And see if you start to feel the activation in your arms. And then bring the arms forward and face the front of your mat. And place that palms on the mat. Come into all four. Tuck the back toes. Push your neck to the back, chin in, looking to that space in between your palms. Keep the ribs in, spine lifting up. And start to engage your core, bringing your navel towards your spine. Take an inhale, and with an exhale, lift your knees, hovering few inches above the mat. Stay for a few breaths. And with your next exhale, lift that hips up and back, come into a downward facing dog. Keep the knees bent for now. And hook your right foot behind your left ankle. Keep the left knee bent. And push the left heel back. Try to bring that left heel to touch the mat, but keeping the left knee bent, so you should feel a stretch in your left calf. And straighten the left knee and turn that left heel towards the right side of your mat and stretch the left calf. So push your hips back and then left heel to the center and swivel the left heel this time to the left side of your mat and gently push the hips and stretch the left calf and then unhook that right foot again, maintaining the knees bent for now. This time, hook the left foot behind the right ankle. Keep the right knee bent as you push that right heel back. Try to bring the right heel towards the mat. Stretching the right calf. And stay breathe and continue to breathe. And straighten the right knee. And swivel that right heel in towards the left side of the mat and gently push your hips back right heel back to the center and swivel the right heel towards the right side of the mat and unhook the left foot and come into your downward facing dog. Press with your both hands against the mat and straighten both knees if that feels good. And you can pedal your legs, bend one knee, straighten the other and switch. And from here, lift your right leg up and flex the right foot. So you want to flex the foot as if you want to bring your right toes to touch your right shin. Of course, they will never touch, but so this is the movement that we want, dorsiflexion. So flex your right foot, keep the right foot straight, right leg straight, sorry, and then swing that right leg and step the right foot forward in front of your left foot. And this time, bring that left leg up, flex the left foot as if you want to bring the left toes to touch your left shin. And then keeping the left leg straight as you swing and step your left foot in front of your right foot. And one more time, lift the right leg, flex the foot, leg straight, and step forward
This time left leg up, flex the foot, and swing to step that left foot beside the right foot. And hopefully by now you are in close to the front of your mat, and your both feet are close or in between your hands. Bend your knees, rest your chest on your thighs, and relax your neck and shoulders. Grab the opposite elbow and just swing side to side. Come back to the center. You can release the hands and shake your head. Say yes. Shake your head. Say no. And raise the head. And from here, if you can, start to straighten the knees. Ground through both of your feet. And start to unroll. Unroll from the base of the spine, your lower back, your upper back, your neck, your head, and come into standing. Arms by your side, palms facing forward. Relax the shoulders. Step your right leg behind your left leg. Inhale. Reach your arms, right arm up. Grab the right wrist with your left hand and pull that right arm towards the left. And release back. Step the feet into parallel. This time, step that left leg behind the right leg. Take an inhale and reach with your left arm up, and then grab the left wrist with your right hand and pull that left arm to the right side. And release the hands. Step back, feet parallel. You can place your hands on your waist and start to lift your heels and place the heels down, heels up and down, and just keep going. This is a very good exercise that you can do when you are waiting in line. It's very beneficial for the ankles and the muscles of the lower leg. Let's do about 10 more. 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, 1, and done. And shake the legs. And let's do some exercises for the toes. So stand about hip width distance and just lift your toes, all the toes, and place them back down. Lift the toes down, and just keep going. When you lift the toes, try to spread them apart as well. And you could continue, or you could try the next one, which is alternatingly lift just the big toes and keep the four toes, the other four toes stay on the mat, and then place the big toes down, lift the other all four toes down, big toes up, big toes down, other toes up, other toes down, and continue. You may need to move more slowly when you are
alternating between your big toes and the other four toes. And release.